Here with Dan Starkey, played Strax on Doctor Who, one of the greatest Santarans ever. So I was just wondering, how has your experience been with WhoFest so far? I mean,
it's been very enjoyable. Yes, it's Sunday today as we're talking, and it's been a nice sort of relaxed event as well, and everyone's been very appreciative. And
this is your first time in Dallas.
In Dallas, yes. I've been through the airport many times. So it's nice to get out of the airport
right.
And actually meet people. So,
yeah, exactly. Cool.
So quite an evolution.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, definitely. So I was wondering, now, if you're Dan Starkey, you're walking along the street and you run into Strax, what happens?
I think, first of all, Strax upbraids me because it's like, who is this weak and puny human individual with a neck? I think he'd probably grab me and accost me. And so like, but I see that your teeth are somewhat... I've got a pleasing gappiness to them. Yes.
Right.
Is this an advantage to you in combat? To which I reply, no, Strax, no, I'm a peaceful person.
Exactly.
I'm a human being.
Right.
Yes, but I'm not sure whether I particularly want to socialise too long with Strax because it's like a dog that you sort of like think it's all right, but it might bite your arm off. You know, so sort of like, looks cute,
right.
But then it's like no. Yeah.
How are you doing?
Yes, keep a respectful distance.
Exactly.
Yes.
Okay. Well, Dan, thank you very much, and I appreciate you talking with me, and hope to see you sometime in the future.
Indeed. Thank you.
Okay, I'm here with Mike Erickson, one of the co-chairs of WhoFest. And Mike, I'd just like to say, as usual, WhoFest has been incredibly awesome. It's been a great experience, and I've enjoyed being here yet again.
Right.
And so just tell me a little bit about some of your experiences being involved with WhoFest.
Well, it's been a long storied saga since we took up the WhoFest mantle after 1991. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we all know the legend and the lore of WhoFest, that it started out as a party in the living room of Tim Miller, one of the WhoFest founders, and it got bigger and bigger and bigger, and it turned into a actual mini convention that we had to cap membership at 1,000 people over at the Crown Plaza. So we took about a year off and came back in 2015 and had a proper convention with guests and autographs and photo ops. And we've kept it going for a couple more after that. And it's just fun, you know, as I say, I mean, sincerely, you know, I just want to see everybody coming out and having fun.
Right.
If all of our attendees are having fun, if the guests are having fun, mm-hmm. I'm over the moon. So
oh, yeah.
all the work is worth it.
Oh, absolutely. And I tell you, you know, one of the things that I have loved about WhoFest is the fact that it's big enough to be a really good convention, but it's small enough at the same time, so that you have that intimacy with the guests, the celebrities, and being able to talk to them, to visit. Unlike most conventions that are just humongous and It's just impossible. And I love that.
Yeah, that's absolutely by design. People ask us, well, can you get Matt Smith? Can you get David Tennant? No, and we don't want him to. We want to keep this small, as you say, small, you know, with this certain amount of people. Gallifrey won before the new series took off. I was the last one before the new series came along in 2005. And there were about 700 people. And it was great because you saw, you could run into everyone else, every other attendee, more or less. Mm-hmm. So you've always found somebody interesting to talk to. But yeah, we like to provide an alternative to Comma Fan Days Palooza, which those are fun, those are great. But it's also fun to have something like this, and some of us really prefer it. So we're happy to provide that, put that on for folks to have a relaxing alternative.
Exactly, and I really hope, you know, that you'll be able to keep it that way, you know, to walk that you know, fine line, you know, being, you know, big enough to really be a success, but small enough to keep, you know, that intimacy with the guests.
Right. That's our hope. If we go on in the future, that we would keep it small.
Right. So, you know, on the topic of the future, what do you kind of foresee for the future of WhoFest?
Well, we're optimistic, but we're going to look over some things. Like I say, we'll certainly, if we have any more information or news, it'll come out on social media and through the email blast. We got a good email list to everybody that's gone to the cons, so we can send that information. So we hope to have some news soon.
Right, okay. So if you're on Facebook, like WhoFest DFW, and that we can get the updates and know what's going on, and hopefully come out for WhoFest 5 and have a good time with all the rest of us out here. So, Mike, right. Thank you very much.
Excellent.
It's been great talking with you.
All right.
Okay, I'm here with Mark Strickson, who played Turlo on Doctor Who during Peter Davison's run. And it's been fantastic seeing you here so far at WhoFest. And how have you been enjoying WhoFest so far?
Well, I now live in New Zealand, and it's a very long way. I live in a town right at the bottom of New Zealand, and so people know how far away that is. It's the town where Captain Scott and Shackleton got their last supplies before going to Antarctica. I live at the end of the world. And it took me 40 hours continuous travel to get here, and it's about 7:30 tonight. It will take me 38 hours to get back. So that is an enormous amount of travel for a 2.5-day visit. So I've had a great time at WhoFest. I'm starting to feel a bit better. I'm just about to get back on a plane again.
And just by the time you start recovering from the jet lag, it's time to go back and experience that again.
Yeah. And it's always nice, actually, if you can take a couple of days off and see a bit of the city and, you know, have a bit of a relax. But unfortunately, I've got to be back to work on Tuesday morning at 9 o'clock. Yeah. So
all hustle and bustle and no time to relax, for the most part. So I was wondering, I know in the past interviews I've heard you say, you know, that you wish that you could, or they could have prolonged Turlo's trying to kill the Doctor.
Yeah.
And what is one thing that you really, as Turlo, would have loved to have been able to do in trying to kill the Doctor?
Well, I would imagine being more successful. and I think that you know, I mean, there's that famous end of episode bit where I've got the rock over the Doctor's head, right?
Yeah.
And then at the beginning of the next episode, there's an explosion and I'm thrown backwards, all right? I would have liked to have gone clever about it and even closer to killing the Doctor so that the Doctor didn't know it was coming, right? So maybe I could have gone something wrong, you know, rewired the TARDIS or something, you know, and been more mischievous.
Right.
So yeah, I would have liked to have been a lot more mischievous.
Yeah, that would have been awesome. I would have loved to have seen that.
Yeah.
But Mark, thank you very much for speaking with me.
My pleasure.
It's been great seeing you here, and I hope to see you again sometime in the near future.
Yeah, I hope so too. I'd say to anybody about WhoFest, it is such a nice convention.
Absolutely.
Not too many people. You get to talk and chat.
Right.
And it's a lovely con.
Absolutely. I love it myself.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you very much.
My pleasure.
Okay, here I'm, you know, WhoFest 4 has been awesome so far, and I'm here with Devin and the Toastmaster for WhoFest. And I've seen you, of course, at Comic Dallas Comic Con, even I think Fan Expo, different, conventions. I think this is your first WhoFest, isn't it?
It's my first as Toastmaster. I've been an attendee and a DJ, actually, the previous two WhoFests. So when they asked me to do Toastmaster for this show, I mean, I don't think they finished the question before I said yes. I've known the people who have run this con forever. I've been a Doctor Who fan since 1979 when I first saw Tom Baker's version on KERA. So it's an automatic lock.
Yeah, Tom was my first Doctor, watching him on LPB in the early 80s. So I'm kind of right there with you.
Sure.
And so, kind of what's your experience been so far with WhoFest? I mean,
it's always good. I love smaller shows that are specifically devoted to one fandom, because there's always great programming that you don't get to see at, you can call them Lion Cons or Celebrity Expo shows. The guests always get a chance to actually have a conversation with the celebrities, and the friends that you make at these genre-specific shows, they're going to be the ones that you wind up having a relationship with afterwards. And that's the experience that I've had at WhoFest, the experience I've had at Galacticon or Gallifrey One, the big Doctor Who show out in L.A. It's always a greater experience. It seems like a more rich value for your time and for your money.
Right. Oh yeah. And yeah, so far my experiences with WhoFest have been very similar to yours. I mean, I also love, the smallness of it, the intimacy that you have with the guests, to visit and to talk. And so that's been really fantastic. So as a Whovian, what would you like to see in the future with WhoFest and Doctor Who in general?
Well, there's so many Doctor Who fans in the North Texas area, and really just the five-state area in general. I mean, we were talking to a couple of fans who drove all the way up from Illinois, and I'd love to see the show grow. The problem that WhoFest and other smaller shows wind up doing is there's so many things on the calendar, it's really hard to get a weekend where you're not competing with not only other shows in your market, but also in the US and Canada, and really globally, really, because we've become so oversaturated with cons. Smaller shows like this have to really fight to grow their fan base and the people they're able to bring in. But I would love to see the show expand and thrive and come back and be strong, because the people who run the show not only know local fandom, but they are incredibly passionate about throwing a great show for every person who walks through the door. And that's what I mean, I would love to, I don't want to see it grow to the level of something like Dallas Comic Con or Fan Expo, but what I would like to see is that it has the same kind of cachet as, you know, maybe Gallifrey 1, because there's the fan base is here to support those kind of numbers, and they cap their numbers at 3,500. So you're not going to have, you're not just be completely elbowing other people to get out of the way.
Right, exactly. Yeah, I'm definitely hoping that WhoFest can walk that fine line between being big enough to succeed, but yet, you know, keep that smallness for the intimacy that you get. So
absolutely.
Yeah. Well, thank you, Devin, very much for talking with me. It's great having you as a Toastmaster. And
it's been a gas. And like I said, I would be here cleaning the rooms after everybody if I had to. But the guests have been great. The attendees have all been incredibly wonderful. We had a charity auction for KERA, which was the first, of course, the place where we all started watching Doctor Who in North Texas. And we raised a lot of money for them, and the people have been very generous with those donations as well. So it's a great time. And if you missed it, why weren't you here?
Yeah. All right. Thank you very much, Devin.
Absolutely. It's my pleasure.
Okay, here I am with Peter Davison, who played the Doctor. And Peter, how has your experience been so far with WhoFest?
It's been a very nice weekend. I think everyone's been very pleasant. It's been nice meeting everyone. It's been everyone's been very. I called them restrained this morning. I think they thought I was being rude, but I didn't mean that. I just meant that it wasn't. They weren't wild and staying up all night and sleeping in the lobby. So everyone's been very pleasant, and it's been nice to see everyone.
Okay. Have you been to Dallas before?
Apparently, I was here in 1991. Someone very kindly informed me, and then produced a photograph of me in 1991, uh-huh. 26 years ago. So that was nice.
Right. Okay. Cool. So I'm wondering. Okay. Now, if you could walk into a TARDIS and go back in time to right before you start production on Doctor Who, what would you tell the younger Peter Davison in regard to playing the Doctor?
I think I just don't worry, in 2017 you will be in Dallas at WhoFest talking about Doctor Number 5.
Right, okay. That'd be a good thing to say, definitely. All right, well, thank you, Peter, for being here. It's been absolutely fabulous seeing you here. And I hope to see you again at another convention in the near future.
26 years, huh?
Right, yeah.
Sir, you gotta come on. Show. No, come on, show's over. Come on. Oops.
Well, mustache.
Oh, this one?